Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you EDTV in this session.
So first, I'll explain basics of EDTV. So EDTV stands for Extended Definition Television. So basics is been discussed first here, and then after I'll explain compression of signals in EDTV, and after that I'll explain MAC encoding format which is there in EDTV. So here we do compression of signal in EDTV, and that compression is been encoded in MAC format, multiplex analog compression that we do it over here. So that will be explained here, and after that I'll explain parameters of EDTV, and then I'll discuss and sum up this session by explaining advantages of EDTV. So let us discuss this session first based on basics of EDTV. So see, EDTV means what? It is extended quality of picture on television. Now see here, EDTV, that is setting a base of digital broadcasting television. So before EDTV, it was quite difficult to have digital broadcasting of television, but after extended definition television format, it was possible to have digital broadcasting. Now here, what is the meaning of extended quality of picture? See, in extended quality of picture, we don't increase resolution of signal, but here we change pattern of video format. And in pattern of video format, you will be finding, like previously there were interlaced scanning which was happening in television system, but after having evaluation means extended definition television, there was a change of interlaced to progressive scanning, where in EDTV we don't have interlaced scanning, here in EDTV we have progressive scanning. So all those things that you will get to know after learning this session. See, it requires different transmission standard but retains normal number of lines and field rate. So here we don't change resolution, we don't change number of lines as well as field rates, as it is there in PAL as well as in NTSC system. So we don't change that, but here we provide extended quality by having progressive scanning. So EDTV intended for delivery of media for DBS system, direct broadcasting satellite system. So here in EDTV, main intention was to deliver media by having DBS system, and that's why there was a change in format of transmission. So I'll show you that change. See, in PAL and NTSC system, information was transmitted by having interleaving form. But for sound information, there was additional carrier, and for stereo type sound, there were two separate carriers. So in NTSC and PAL system, there were multiple signals that were in parallel, they were being transmitted. One is for video signal, one is for sound signal, and for stereo type sound, there were two separate carriers that have been forwarded. So multiple signals were forwarded or transmitted parallelly, and that was creating some issues. So that I'll show you. Like, see, that was creating a problem of bits, and because of problems regarding interference, there was cross luminance as well as cross color effect, and that was more associated with the region where high color saturation was there. So the problem of bits that was happening because of multiple carriers were being forwarded, and in that time period there was a need of so many channels, so it was not possible to increase bandwidth of channel with same resolution. So this problem has to get resolved by same bandwidth, and that was been done by EDTV, where it have adopted MAC encoding system. MAC means multiplexed analog components. So I'll show you how multiplexing is been happening, and that is what happening with respect to time division multiplexing. So I'll show you by format how it has been happening, and by this MAC operating encoding technique, signals are not transmitted simultaneously, but that were being transmitted in sequence, and that is what we are a little bit to see in next slides. So you'll be knowing like how we'll be multiplexing that. But before we multiplex it, it is compulsory to have compression of that time domain signal, as there are multiple signals. So if you want to send signal in time sequence, then obviously we need to compress that with respect to time, and then only we can forward it, right? So let us discuss that first, compression of signals. So see, signals are not transmitted simultaneously in each line, but here we are transmitted in sequence, so it is compulsory to compress it. Then only three signals can be sended. Like see, if I say 1, 2, and 3 signals are there, and you want to send it in sequence, right? So obviously these three signals that we need to compress it first, then only we can send it in sequence, right? So this is what the basic case which we need to do it in ADTV. So for video signal, there are three signals, Y, R minus Y, and B minus Y. Y is there for luminance, R minus Y and B minus Y signals are there for chrominance information, means color information. Also, there is a need of sound transmission. For normal sound transmission, there is single carrier, and for stereo sound transmission, there are two carriers. So 64 microsecond, again that is getting divided into three parts. One is for this luminance information. Second is for this color information, that is R minus Y and B minus Y. And third is for sound information. So let us have this MAC encoding format. So it will get, you will get better, like what is extended division television. See, in MAC encoding format of ADTV, 64 microsecond, that we divide into three different parts. One is for sound data. So sound data has been compressed for 3 microsecond duration. Second is for chrominance data, and that is what we are encoding it for 17 microsecond, where in chrominance data, R minus Y and B minus Y data is there, and that is what we are compressing it in this period of 17 microsecond. And luminance data, that has been assigned with 34 microsecond, and here there is a gap of 10 microsecond for zero level of color difference. So that is how in sequence we are sending data of three different signals, sound, chrominance and luminance of the data. So that is how we compress this three signal, and we are sending that in sequence of 64 microsecond frame. So here this is the basic thing which we do it in ADTV, enhanced definition television, and by doing this we are avoiding interference of bit, where we avoid that cross color information and cross interference of luminance information at higher saturation level of television. So that is what we are avoiding it by having this MAC encoding format. Now let us have different parameters of ADTV. See, if you observe resolution of ADTV, then that is not changing. It is 480 pixels only. But here 480p means this is what progressive type scanning which we do. Rather, we were been doing interlaced scanning in previous systems with PAL and NTSC. Here aspect ratio could be 16:9 or 4:3, and you will be finding pixels per frame, that will be 640 into 480 for 4:3 aspect ratio, and 720 to 480 with 16:9 aspect ratio. So these were the different parameters with which ADTV was functioning. And type of scanning, that was progressive scanning, right? We were not been doing over here with interlaced scanning. Now let us discuss some advantages which is there with ADTV. See, elimination of cross color and cross luminance. That is what the basic idea which is there with EDTV. See, improved luminance and color resolution, that is there with EDTV compared to normal PAL and NTSC system. There is also improvement in noise, and there will be less distortion and intermodulation which is happening in EDTV. And you will be finding there is more efficient use of transmission of channel by sending 3 information in sequence with 64 microsecond frame format with MAC encoding technique. And here it retains high capacity of digital sound data transmission. And it provides wider aspect ratios to the picture, where you will be finding with PAL and NTSC system, it was been designed to have 4 to 3 aspect ratio only, but now it is possible to have 16 to 9 aspect ratio by having this.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.